if you talk about chimps, let's talk about this new Planet of the Apes movie that I want to see badly.
Is there previews out yet?
Remember the last time we were all psyched?
They got us, but I don't think they're going to get us with this one.
Nah.
You think they're going to get us? No.
They fucked up the last one.
Yep.
That was a no-brainer to make Planet of the Apes
with Marky Mark.
They fucked that movie up so
bad. How did they
fuck
that up, though? Let me know. Because you know what? Can I just say, I'm fuck what you say guy for this week.
Oh, okay.
Fuck what everybody says, and I'm going to start out by saying this. Yeah. There's three other gangster movies I'd rather see than Godfather.
Okay.
And two other Vietnam movies I'd rather see than Apocalypse Now. And those are the
I know what they are.
The functioning great movies.
All right, can we guess the Godfather movies? The three you would rather see than Godfather?
Mm-hmm. You could.
Goodfellas
was that was obvious.
Casino.
That was my second.
And those are
this
the two.
It's three.
Oh, it's three.
Three gangster movies.
The third is the tricky one, right?
No.
Scarface?
You might smack me in the face.
No.
No.
That's stereotypical of what you did right there. Black people like Scarface.
They love Scarface.
No.
Okay.
I'm dead serious. I've seen it.
Dead men don't wear plaid.
Donnie Brasco.
That is a good one.
And only, I can't get into a theater discussion with anybody that's angry, but I those three movies I'd rather watch first, even though I know The Godfather's great.
Right, right.
That's not shocking.
I'd rather watch those three movies.
That's not shocking.
The Godfather.
That's not
but
shocking.
But in terms of people that tell you what to fucking watch and tell you what's good.
Yeah.
I like those three better. Entertainment value. I couldn't argue that you didn't think the scene the way it fucking flowed through this.
I didn't get it.
I mean, I love it. I love the movie, but I'd rather watch fucking Casino.
Yeah,
that's not
anytime.
What was the other one?
Donnie Brasco.
No, the other question.
Vietnam.
Come on, Platoon.
Easily.
Yeah.
Easily.
Platoon is great.
And Full Metal Jacket.
Full Metal Jacket. Great.
Platoon, easily,
Platoon's great.
10,000 times more than I would watch. I watch Apocalypse Now 100 times because I think I'm supposed to.
Yeah, yeah.
And I'm sitting there and I'm going, oh, Robert Duvall, yeah. I'm feeling it.
Yeah,
oh, fucking Kornhauser or whatever the fuck his name is. Kirkenbauer that Marlon Brando played. But I'm just like, eh.
Kurtz.
Charlie Sheen.
Colonel Kurtz.
Colonel Kurtz. But I watch Platoon.
Yeah.
It's on cable right at the moment. I watch every time it comes on.
It's great.
I don't get sick of it. And I don't I don't get tired of saying Sergeant Barnes might be the best character in a movie ever.
I just watched it 2 days ago. And I was thinking the same thing.
I'm watching them all. So I'm looking at this Planet of the Apes movie.
Yeah.
Okay, here's what I want to know. Mm-hmm. I want to know movies that are considered bad. Mm-hmm. I want to know why Waterworld was bad.
I love Waterworld.
I want to know why they told me it was a shitty movie, and I watch it every time it comes on,
and I love it.
Why is it a bad movie?
Yeah.
I can't answer that
You tell
question.
Me. Because I don't know, because I watch it, and I love Waterworld.
I watch him throw that little girl in the water. Kevin Costner is a complete asshole in that movie.
He is.
He chops their hair off. He won't fuck ugly, what's her name, Triplehorn. And he leaves the island on a fucking worst ship that he had.
Yeah, on a horrible
he
little
dinghy.
He loves
the ocean.
He just loves it.
I watch Waterworld, and I'm going to tell you something else I watched that they try to tell me stunk. The Postman.
Love The Postman.
Really?
They told me The Postman sucked, and I'm not listening to him no more.
Because it's Waterworld on the land.
I enjoyed The Postman.
It's the same movie. On the land.
I love that movie.
Love it.
Why did you tell me that movie stunk?
It's a great subject today.
What a great bad guy.
The guy's great.
Like, I used to fix copy machines. And now he's like fucking kicking ass, taking names.
Dude, I'm sitting there going, okay, you said the first, the Planet of the Apes remake was bad.
Yeah.
Why was it bad?
Why?
It's not memorable because I can't even tell you one scene from the movie anymore.
Now you got me thinking.
But why is it bad?
Now you got me thinking why.
I think there were high expectations. I think Marky Mark took you out of the movie a little bit.
They went off.
Because you're like, hey, yeah, that's Marky Mark.
They went off the original. They went completely off the original. And we thought it was going to be.
Well, that's a reboot, though.
Yeah.
They went for the reboot. Made it really dark. That's all I can say about it. I haven't seen the movie in years.
You see how fast you would say it stunk?
Yeah, true.
But it's like, why did it stink? Now, I'm not going to say it was a great movie.
We didn't give you a good answer. I understand that.
That's what I mean. So it's like, we will say some things that come right out of, like, we go, Apocalypse Now is the standard of... But I go,
right,
I don't,
but no.
I'm not sure.
I, you know, I would say it again. I think people had a problem with Marky Mark in that movie.
Really?
Yeah, he was Marky Mark. They probably should have went with some kind of unknown, I'm
thinking. The apes were great.
The apes looked all right, right?
Yeah, they looked great.
I think, if you remember, the trailer was spectacular.
Oh, yeah,
that's true.
It was. I think the trailer was so good. It was
hard to live up to the trailer.
But the trailer for this new one is phenomenal.
It looks good, man.
I haven't seen it yet.
It's phenomenal. Yeah. I got to see this movie, man.
It does look good.
I got to tell you, I have a problem with Marky Mark in movies. Mark Wahlberg. Yeah, because you go, once again, that's Marky Mark.
Boogie Nights? It's fucking fantastic.
Boogie Nights, not so much.
Boogie Nights.
Because he changed his look enough.
Love Boogie Nights.
In all the other movies, he made a deal with the producers that he wasn't going to cut his hair or something. He had to have his regular Marky Wahlberg hair.
Marky Mark.
I think
hairdo.
They're looking for a something version of Matt Damon, but yeah. Matt Damon is the same exact version of Mark Wahlberg, but he makes better choices.
Did they come out about the same time, or was Marky Mark doing movies?
I just think Matt Damon did something with himself that he's borderline. Gets to do good the same kind of movies that maybe Johnny Depp gets to do, but he's not as involved as Johnny Depp.
Yeah, yeah.
But he's really good.
Can I ask you something? Actors that take you out of movies because they're so fucking famous that you're like, oh, I'll say it again. That's Marky Mark. Do you have a short list of guys like that?
That is so famous or so bad?
Well...
Travolta's terrible in everything he's in.
Nobody's that famous for me to go...
No.
Yeah. Where it's tough for them to play a character because you just know the guy so
not if
well.
He's good. I mean,
well, that's why I'm saying.
DiCaprio.
Is there a short list of actors that will do that to you?
I know there's a short list of actors. Another thing I'm going to do is stop saying like Jack Nicholson's great.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm watching and I
You're
go,
right.
What's going on here?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. This guy is him again.
Yeah.
Meaning, I'm not going to say he's not a great him.
But I can't
say he's a great actor. I think he's a great comfortable guy on film.
Yeah.
Wow, this looks badass. I haven't seen this
movie,
yet.
This Planet of the Fucking Apes looks. If this one sucks,
go back to the beginning of the trailer. Let's give it a listen. Real quick.
We love watching trailers.
I know.
It's
please.
The dumbest thing to do on radio, but we love doing it.
People can play along at home.
Yeah.
Get your computer. Goddammit. Look up Rise of the Planet of the Apes.
Looks good. I think
this does look pretty good. Damn good. Because they used this.
Huge potential for millions of people. Our therapy enables the brain to repair itself.
Nice.
We call it the cure. I want you to start testing on chimps ASAP. When we test one subject, I want to make sure it's stable. I designed the 112 for repair, but Caesar's gone way beyond that.
You mean increased intelligence?
The skills that far exceed that of a human counterpart.
This is wrong, Will.
It works.
And what about Caesar? Where does he fit in?
That chimp's company property.
He hasn't spent any time with other chimps.
Oh, shit.
They're not people, you know.
You're trying to control things that are not meant to be controlled.
Oh, shit, yo. Oh, shit.
Got the cure.
He's got the cure. He's giving it to his buddies.
They are contaminated. Put those apes down.
You have no idea what you're dealing with.
Oh, man. That chimp gave a nasty-ass look.
Slow turn.
They bust out.
And they call him The Caesar.
Yeah, The Caesar.
The Caesar.
Caesar!
Oh, shit. They're rioting. That's pretty badass. Now it's just thousands of fucking...
This movie looks...
That looks badass.
Spectacular.
It really looks badass.
I cannot wait to see this movie, man.
Oh, that's right around the corner, too, man.
Yeah. Oh,
a couple weeks away.
August 5th.
I can't wait to see that movie.
Yeah.
One piece of suspension of disbelief, gunless apes ain't winning. That's all I'm saying. It's just gunless apes. We will what they call collateral damage
through
any apes.
Wait,
there's children in the school.
Snake and ape. Snake and ape the fucking bridge.
We
gunless apes.
There's apes in the wire.
Yeah,
chips in the wire.
Don't matter.
We will fucking
drop
light
it
them
on
up.
My paws. On my paws. I take full responsibility.
It's a hell of a war.
Lovely fucking war. Yeah.
It looks fucking good.
Yeah, that's going to be a great one.
But Green Lantern looked good.
And? I didn't see it.
Dude. Not good.
Dude.
Yeah. Not good.
And I have the same funny feeling about Captain America.
We just talked to the man
yesterday. Yeah, yeah,
The Captain America guy?
We talked to the Captain America.
He's too...
He's a Boston guy.
Too what?
He's Boston.
Too white bread?
Those two guys...
Too milk toast.
...are, they're two finger air gun guys. Ryan Reynolds was in the comic books. And here's the bad thing about what's going on with these comic books.
Yeah.
Adults are into comics. Children now are not into comic books the way adults are. Some father's trying to get his goofy son to be into them, but they just...
You're right.
The paper feels funny.
Yeah.
You know? And you think of heroes that would be good on television, and like Aquaman would be tremendous if they did a rated R. And they took advantage of the abyss.
Really
the
made
ocean.
It fucking
the
crazy.
The ocean is creepy.
Yeah.
Anything I see about the ocean scares the
dog. The
ocean's
scary.
And a man lives in the ocean. Mm-hmm. It has to be some kind of deep, dark Aquaman.
Yeah,
it can't be fun guy.
It can't be a guy in the Bahamas.
Swims
with
like
that nice colored water.
Yes. Swimming with
the
dolphins.
Steel drums.
Yeah, yeah. Doing like the dolphin dances and
it has to
jumps.
Be the creepiness of the abyss.
So you've never went scuba diving. I know exactly what you're describing.
That weirdness.
Oh, the darkness where you look ahead and you know there's just darkness for thousands
of miles.
And there's
a fucking dude
and
living there.
Some shit out there.
Yeah, that's
you
scary.
Can't see.
Who communicates with the lobsters?
Yeah.
Do you understand? Like they're gonna fuck it up.
Yeah.
Because Aquaman.
Well, I don't know
theory,
if they will because they're going dark with a lot of these superhero movies.
No, they're not.
Finally.
No, they're
they
not.
Kinda are.
We'll name one besides the Great Dark Knight. One
well,
dark.
Mr. Captain America told us that that's going to be a bit dark.
Really? Is that
he
what he
said? Not. It's,
come on.
It's more like the Iron Man, though, tone.
That was,
where it's got a little
Iron
bit
Man was kind of dark.
Nah, Iron Man
little,
was good,
yeah.
But it wasn't dark.
Wasn't dark.
It wasn't dark
there was a good
all.
Balance of not cartoony dark. And darkness.
He even said
movie.
Not
no.
Dark Knight-ish.
Who?
You know?
Who in my Iron Man was dark? What part?
You didn't think so?
Not a drop of darkness. The Dark Knight, the original Batman, which I have finally come on. I used to say Superman's 1978, best comic book movie ever made.
Wow. Well, the original?
The original Christopher Reeve was stupendous. Batman Begins took that over for me.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the best. It's better than Dark Knight to me only for this.
Mm-hmm.
When I was a kid and watched Batman, I used to go, who built the Batmobile? It was a suspension of disbelief.
Yeah, you're right.
Who built the Batmobile? Was it, you know, and who built the Batcave?
Right.
Who built the little thing that went down, that little gate that went down
under
and went back
up? Under the stately Wayne Manor.
Who built the thing that you rip open the head and push the button and you go down?
Who
did that? Batman Begins added...
Alfred would fucking...
Dude.
Know that shit, tip up that fucking...
That Morgan Freeman character, okay? Mm-hmm.
Who plays Morgan Freeman in every movie?
Who plays Morgan Freeman in every movie? If you... Because you are speaking for a couple of crackers out there that said, fuck you, nigga.
Sorry.
Jack Nicholson, but Morgan Freeman is this ever
I'm getting
character.
My short list together.
It's Morgan Freeman is him in
I'd
every
like
movie.
To say the sisters never got to him.
There's a few
so
great
narrating.
Actors... It's a short list of great actors.
Yeah.
Robert De Niro, even though he's been quite fucking up lately, but he deserves it. Yeah. Young De Niro is
great.
Still the greatest
Raging
actor I've ever
Bull
seen.
Raging Bull De Niro is amazing.
Denzel
is
second.
Denzel.
Denzel has done things where you go, that motherfucker can act.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I put up there, maybe above all.
Oh.
This motherfucker's so good.
Oh, shit.
Daniel Day-Lewis.
Really, yeah.
This cocksucker.
Where the fuck has he been?
He only does a movie every 10 years and gets an Oscar.
Where the fuck is
Gangs of New York.
Gangs of New York was fucking amazing.
Yeah. He's the only guy, he's the only method actor that I truly love. Like a guy who I could tell sits on fucking set and he's that dude whole time.
Yeah, don't try to talk to Daniel Day-Lewis.
Yeah, he's
You're
just,
talking to the butcher. That's the fucking guy.
I think he's probably he's probably one of the great actors of all time. But in terms of being real reality, I think De Niro, the shit he did when he was good, when he played Max Cady,
the old days.
Max Cady
was a great character.
Is
too.
Tremendous.
Absolutely.
And then Denzel in his glory cry.
Yeah.
The best.
Yeah,
I mean, it just
I forgot how good he was in Glory.
Tremendous actor, man. So there's a few, but I don't put Nicholson up there. Pacino was pretty good when he was not
over the top. Pacino
before over the top Pacino, he was great.
But he was not. See, but he was the same Pacino before he became over the top Pacino.
I don't know.
He was this Pacino. But, like, watch out!
But yeah, right? he was this guy.
Yeah.
No, he was this guy kind of just.
In every movie, he didn't go.
My father's business. I'm gonna take a legit. I'm gonna. And then
Even in The Godfather, he was that for like
a little bit.
When he yelled at Kay for getting the abortion.
No, not over the top. The other guy.
The quiet one.
The quiet guy. He was that guy for a minute, and then Sin of a Woman kind of took him into.
Hoo-ah. The hoo-ah got him.
Now some guys have great presence, you know, and that's like Pesci.
Pesci.
You know, he's doing him, but he has great. This is just a fan.
I'm just
talking as a fan of movies and shit.
Yeah.
I mean, and actresses, I just say there's only one actress alive, and that's Meryl Streep. I mean, other than that, do I see actresses be able to be as big as her? Not really.
Well, I only like Pesci as that guy. I don't like Pesci in any other fucking role.
What has he done that's not?
You don't even know. Really.
Home Alone. In a comedy,
but he was Pesci though.
Yeah, but
he was good in Home Alone.
Yeah, but I like him being you Jew motherfucker.
I get what you're saying,
that's the guy.
But that's an exception to what you're trying to say.
I'm gonna take your fucking head. I'm gonna stick it through that fucking hole. That shit. There's no one better at doing that guy.
And being a little dude, and he convinces you that he stabbed a giant in his neck with a pencil.
Hey, yeah, it's fantastic.
I knew this was coming. Both of you guys liked Waterworld, and I can't argue that point because I don't even remember seeing Waterworld.
I've watched it many times.
It's been way too long.
Many times.
But
watching it, thinking this sucks.
Hold on.
Yeah, why?
Well, with that said, Ace in Pittsburgh is going to challenge you, Patrice. Ace.
Yes.
Ace is high.
Good morning. First of all, I know I'm walking into a losing battle with Patrice.
Oh.
Not true. I'm open
to... No, you're tough.
I'm open.
You're tough in a debate, sir.
I'm open to seeing why does Waterworld suck.
Right.
Why does
you're
it suck?
Tough, though,
let's hear it.
Well, there is an inkling of hope being that Jimmy changed his mind on Face Off, so I do have a little bit of hope.
I hate
and
Face
I saw
Off.
And by the way,
just saw it recently too.
I wanted to tweet after I watched Face Off. It is bad.
All right.
Jimmy hit me hard. It's
fucking bad.
It's so bad. And you know what I realized about Face Off? Is that John Woo.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're painted in a corner about being you.
You got it.
And you
want
to grow, but you grow, but you can't move on from being you.
You got to do the slow motion, two guns in your hand, sideways.
He was pretending to be him.
Yes.
Directing that movie.
Right.
And it even got worse as I watched it. It's bad.
And Nicolas Cage is another one that plays Nicolas Cage in every movie.
And he's
over the top.
We're getting that short list together. Now we got Marky Mark, Morgan Freeman, but he pulls it he pulls it off.
He's in the Pesci zone.
You watch Shawshank? Who else is playing that role in Shawshank?
Get the fuck out of here. He's a Pesci role.
Right.
He's that guy.
Yeah.
He's amazing as him.
But he doesn't change too much.
He was even great in Bruce Almighty.
I'm saying he pulls it off.
Okay. As God. Like,
Nicolas Cage plays Nicolas Cage in every fucking movie. You get Nicolas Cage every single time.
Deep shit, Obi. He is doing straight to
fuck. He's got
to
take anything.
I know. He's
bad
movies. He's had a fall. Ace, did you explain the Waterworld thing?
What you got?
Well, look, the Kevin Costner thing kind of goes along with the Nicolas Cage premise. He's the same guy in every movie, nearly. He has no emotion.
He was the Waterworld guy in The Postman.
But see, I'm going to tell you something. We're talking movies.
Same guy that was on the
now,
horse.
Now, you can't. Right. Yeah. When you look at Schwarzenegger, you go movie for movie. Schwarzenegger is him. So you go, hey, is Running Man good? Is the sixth whatever good?
Yeah, Sixth Day.
The Sixth Day wasn't a great film.
No.
Running Man was an all-timer to me.
Yeah.
But they're both just Schwarzenegger. So we're talking Kevin.
A pregnant guy in Junior. I'm just throwing that out there.
Right. But Schwarzenegger will do bad movies, then he'll do good ones.
Yeah.
Kevin Costner, who was Kevin Costner in The Untouchables, which is another all-timer.
Yeah,
that might be another gangster film that I watched before Godfather.
That's a good one.
And I'll give you credit for that. But
so,
the thing is, if you're a movie fan, like a real like snobby movie buff, you're not going to like movies like Waterworld and The
Batman. The problem,
yeah,
sir.
Yeah, but who gives a shit?
The problem is, do you like any of the Friday the 13ths? Like,
yeah.
I don't like them all, but I love three. So it's like, it's about what you like.
Did you like Dances with Wolves?
I could not watch it. I'm supposed to watch it.
Yeah, yeah.
I cannot watch,
can't watch two seconds
of that fucking
movie.
I try and try.
It's so long.
But I'm going to tell you what.
Plotting, yeah.
There's a lot of things in movies that I can't recall right now.
An editor.
But one of them that I can't stand is My People. We will be there with our people and our people.
You didn't like the
love
Indian
our people.
The
any movie where Indians are saying my people. And then my people, they say my people. My people are
my people.
And there's one fucking younger one that wants to change everything.
Yeah,
and then the older one, the my bad name.
No. Back
they annoy me.
Tonka.
Yeah, but the fact Kevin Costner stunk in Waterworld is not a good argument. I tell you why, man. The movie in itself, Dennis Hopper was very entertaining
as
the boss of the worst people on the world.
the fucking smokers.
Where
did he get the smokers from?
He was good as
horrible.
A loner. Guy who lives on it, escapes the smokers, fishes for giant sea monsters when he's hungry, fucking can breathe underwater.
Doesn't care about no
the
little girl.
The idea of that movie was pretty fucking... Matter of fact, Waterworld is close to what Aquaman should be.
Should be.
Okay, let me ask you this.
All right.
When he gets to the atoll, and the Chinese guy wants him to mate with his daughter...
Yes.
And they find out he's a mutant.
Yes.
And they flip shit... Well, that doesn't make any sense. You live in a world filled with water. Wouldn't you want to be nice to a guy that can breathe underwater?
Well, in that scene, sir, I will be fair. I've seen this movie so many times, and that's one of the scenes that could bother you.
Yeah, yeah.
But here's the problem with that. Here's the thing about that scene.
Yeah.
They were offended anyway. They were looking for any reason to kill this guy.
Right.
Because they were dying. He said that.
Yeah.
You people are dying.
People are dying.
There's nothing. And... He explained it later, really, why he didn't fuck the girl is because he's never been with one. He's some weird mutant with web toes. So when he said no and they wanted to attack him.
He got vaginas behind his ears.
It was based on them being unreasonable weirdos.
Right.
But there was the guy who was protecting them who said, you're not going to do this. Like, he was a reasonable guy. He said, what are you doing? They were pissed off that he wouldn't mate with their little thing that they were offering.
Yeah.
So the suspension of disbelief, I can see where it could take you out. Like, what the fuck are they so mad about?
Right.
But they're weirdos. Everybody's
fucking
weirdos.
Yeah, they're all
weirdos.
Fucked up.
They live on water.
They've been
they
sitting
drink
in that
their own piss.
And,
they fucking they love ski boots. They want ski boots.
They just wanted his ski boots.
So this fucking weirdo who and trust me, he was a weirdo because he breathed underwater.
Yeah.
Not everybody mutated into of half fish, half man thing.
Right.
That's how he got land. They was like, where the fuck are you getting this land from?
Actually, the guy that looked like he was from Whitesnake wanted the fucking boots.
Yeah, the other
David Coverdale wanted the fucking boots.
I wouldn't even say Waterworld's a good, bad movie. Like, I would I enjoy Waterworld. It was well done. Come it's on. Just that people were anti Kevin Costner at the time.
Yep. I enjoyed the exhibit at Disney. It was awesome.
Hey, you know something?
Man, I love
it. That was great.
Those actors were amazing.
And the fucking jet skis and shit.
Exactly.
That is great.
You know how to work those jet skis.
That is great.
Hey, so you done with this?
Yeah, you know, I came into this argument thinking I would need a plethora, if you will, of arguments for you.
I don't know. I think Patricia's forced me to watch Waterworld
just because he sucked.
Oh,
just because Kevin Costner stunk. You is no see if I say that I don't think Jack Nicholson's a fantastic actor, he makes fantastic movies.
Yeah.
Like if you add up 20 actors and you go, okay, if I was stuck, which actor would I take his collection of films and be stuck with for the rest of my life? I say Schwarzenegger, and then. But you could easily say Jack Nicholson. If you're a real movie fan, he has such a wide range of shit you can watch.
Mm-hmm. De Niro.
I mean, he's amazing.
De Niro. De Niro did a couple good comedies, and he's got the gangster stuff. He's all over the place.
Midnight Ride, I think, is the best comedy I've ever seen.
Nice Variety.
That was fucking hysterical.
I think it's still one of the best movies I've ever seen.
He's suffering from fistophobia in a minute.
He was so good.
Fucking hilarious.
A bunch of people want to add Gene Hackman to the list. He plays Gene Hackman. Every time.
Gene Hackman.
I know he's phenomenal. I'm not saying that this means they're hacky.
It just what's the one him and Denzel did?
Oh shit!
In the submarine, and
I hate
closed movies. That's
come closed. On. Here it is. Come on, people. Where is it?
The submarine movie.
Red October.
No,
that was the other one.
Gray Lady Down.
No,
dude.
Crimson Tide.
Dude. Crimson Tide. Very good.
Crimson Tide. Thank you, Adam.
His exchange. I love Gene Hackman as Gene Hackman.
Yeah.
Like, even in Superman, original Superman, it just was, I think he's a phenomenal dude.
Oh, fuck, man. Forgot about
that. He was great as Lex Luthor.
Mr. Luthor?
I got another one that saves face even in bad movies because he's so damn good, but he plays himself in every movie. Robert Duvall.
Really?
I would say
Robert Duvall.
Phenomenal.
And I'm not saying that means he's a bad actor, but he definitely plays Robert Duvall in just about every movie.
Colors, he was Robert
and
Duvall.
And even in the shittiest movie where he has a cameo, he does his part to perfection every fucking time.
Let me think of that for just a second.
Let me say,
not sure.
De Niro might be the greatest. I'm going to put him as the greatest from his to recall some of the shit is, but the Russian roulette scene in The Deer Hunter.
Oh my God! Right,
is the greatest scene I've ever seen in a movie.
Wow. When he's just telling him to do it, Nicky, come on, show these motherfuckers. That is some of the best acting.
And he goes, he looks at the guy, the fucking VC, and goes, "Oh, you." His frustration of wanting to kill this guy. There's nothing better.
His face. He fucking shows with his face the hate.
It's even on
fucking
YouTube.
Walking.
The Deer Hunter.
Walking became a different entity. Walking just became a different person.
Come on!
He's not that guy.
These fuckers. Go ahead, Nicky. It's gonna be all right.
That's a bad
slap.
It's gonna
be all right. Go ahead.
Yeah, stop. And they're laughing at him. Didn't you hate these fucking Vietnamese?
Motherfucker.
Oh, man, you fucking hated them.
I do three bullets. Three. We do three, huh? One, two, three.
How do they not know what he's up to? How do these dumb fucking motherfuckers not know what he's up to?
This fucking movie.
Come on.
Fucking protest.
We ain't giving him three fucking bullets. He's the maniac of this group.
Three? We do three.
We do three bullets.
Three.
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 We give you a gun with three bullets in it.
Oh, look at De Niro.
He's great in this, man.
Oh, my God.
You'll give three. How about four and the machine gun?
How about machete?
We give you RPG.
It's like Russian machete.
Grenades. And rope ladder. And the fact that they're in the middle of fucking nowhere, like with this shit going on.
And they're all laughing, you motherfucker. He just starts smiling at him.
There. Throws the gun down. There.
I do 130 round banana clip.
Oh, smack him.
And walking so pathetic in this, man.
But as we all would be.
I know.
Of course.
Like De Niro's the fucking man in this right here.
Ouch.
He's like,
Oh.
God damn it. It's going to be all right, Nicky. Go ahead, shoot.
Oh.
Go, Nicky.
Oh, grab me. Yeah, this. Oh, these. You just hated these fucks.
Oh,
you got.
You're going to die. He's so fucking frustrated. Holy shit.
Yeah, that is a great fucking scene, man. Now he knows they got one in the fucking chamber. Now he knows. Now he's looking at him like, hey, we got it. He's crying.
He's crying.
He's crying like, we fucking got a loaded chamber right now. These motherfuckers are dead. He's like, I got it.
Yeah,
these dummies. All right. Yeah, you're dead. You're fucking dead. The way he looks at him right there.
Oh.
Like, you are so dead. Oh, De Niro's great. He just starts laughing and then goes all serious again. Working up that fucking moment where he blows their fucking brains out. Ah, that's fantastic. Yeah, bitch.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Wow. You hated those fucking guys. You fucking hated those guys.
I'm telling you, that is, it's hard. And I'm going to tell you, Barnes after, Sergeant Barnes, after he fucking frags
Elias.
In the room
with
Elias's boys,
yep,
punking them.
Y'all loved life.
Is very close.
Yep.
Very, like, at the end of the scene, you go, good God, I want to be that guy one day.
Yeah.
In a situation.
Barnes.
And there's things in that scene, I rewind, he spits on Sheen.
Yeah.
He fucking, I shit on all you. He's going to kill Charlie. He's really going to kill him. And fucking Anthony Quinn's kid is like, don't do it, Barnes.
And
he cuts his eye. And it's just death.
It's fantastic.
What do you all know about death? Like
he's all fucked up.
Yeah. He's all fucked up. Movies. I can't get enough of them.
You know what? One scene that's fantastic with him is when they're playing fucking poker, and the other guy tells the lieutenant, he goes, "What are you saving up to be, Jewish?" And Barnes looks down like, "Whoa!" And he actually finds that so funny that Barnes dips his head down and goes like, "Whoa!" This fucking killer, this guy that had his face blown apart, he found that hysterical where he had to start laughing.
Sergeant Barnes in platoon, you know, it's just, you go, you watch something like that and you go, you know, you, it makes you mad at Hollywood sometimes because how can they not have something else from Tom Berenger? Berenger has become, now he's like an old fat man like Val Kilmer.
Yeah.
When the fuck did Val Kilmer become a fat man?
A long time ago.
He's a fat old guy.
A fat old do.
He was a young fucking like.
Val's been fat
the Hollywood
for a long
guy.
Time now.
You don't realize how much time
wow,
has passed.
Wow, look at the third picture.
Oh
in.
My God. Wow.
Go third picture.
He
in.
Was sexy guy for.
Look at this. Him with the. Wait, oh
God. My God.
No, go back. Go back where you're spinning. Where you're spinning the volleyball on his finger from fucking Top Gun.
Oh my God. That time
he
is
used to be, he used to be
off.
Sexy guy.
He was fucking.
He was the Doors.
The It guy.
Yeah. He was that guy. He was Batman
that guy.
For a minute.
I think yes. He changed after the Doors. He started getting fat.
Wow.
But he's a fat old dude.
Yeah.
Meaning he can't get back to that guy.
No.
And Tom Berenger plays like he's always a senator guy now. You know,
yeah,
he's
yeah.
He's a fat senator
he
guy.
He can't be the Barnes guy anymore.
He's starting to look like John Goodman in some of these photos.
Oh, my God. Is he fucking fat?
Holy shit.
What happened? Wow.
Berenger and Platoon.
Yeah, it's...
Like, I go, this guy's my new favorite motherfucker. I'm gonna tell you who they played out, too, that you go, oh, big time, big time.
Yeah.
They played out Ving Rhames.
Uh-huh.
Like, he was, oh, shit, this motherfucker's gonna be the new...
Badass
it's
motherfucker.
Like, nah, we're gonna make him... no. Yeah. We're not gonna let him be who you think we're gonna let him be.
I loved him in the fucking remake Dawn of the Dead. That was fucking great.
But that was a good movie.
That was a great fucking movie.
That was a good movie.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh.
God damn.
Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah.
God damn, boy. But I was just been watching movies. That's just lately.
I've been doing the same
movies.
Thing.
Nothing.
And the same fucking movies I've been watching. And they're fantastic.
I saw Harry Potter. So.
I heard that.
It was all right.
I've never seen one.
You've never seen Harry Potter
only because
movies.
You know, there's some movies you go, it took, I'm going to tell you what, this may be sacrilegious. I may lose a lot of white friends behind this.
Oh, shit. I know what you're going to say. Lord of the Rings.
No.
No?
Oh, okay. Lord of the Rings.
Fuck me running.
I actually.
Right.
I could not get through, I haven't watched the entire Raging Bull.
Oh, wow.
Can I apologize to white people for that?
Just I want to thank Patrice for dropping in today. They're telling us you have to go, Patrice.
You just blew the whole hour.
I know.
You just did a brilliant hour.
You fucking
and in one statement, you just fucked up the whole hour.
We were going to go to break.
Oh, my God.
We were
going
to go to break.
I blew it.
You blew it.
I tried because I know I'm supposed to.
Oh, boy.
I just don't know
you should have kept that to yourself.
I don't know how to watch it.
It's a masterpiece.
Oh, my God. I'm watching.
I know, I know.
It's a masterpiece.
I don't know how to watch it.
God. You don't know how to watch it.
I don't know how. Tell me how to watch it.
Oh, brother.
Do you understand?
Oh, my God. Just watch it. How's that?
Oh, my God.
The
fucking end of that movie where he's just fat in that club.
It's amazing.
It's when he's punching.
Requiem for a heavyweight. It's
amazing.
It's all that.
Look at it.
It's fantastic.
Yeah.
And a streetcar named Desire, I tried.
I've never seen that.
I wish Patrice was in when we were doing the Mickey Rooney thing, too.
Oh, my God.
Maybe after the break.
Maybe we might have to revisit.
After the break, we might have to revisit.
Might have to revisit.
Okay.
Because it's just way too funny.
I
didn't realize that scene was in that movie.
Yeah, Patrice.
Can I apologize,
though? You can apologize.
Not that I'm proud of it. I just can't.
I would never ask you for an apology, except for this situation.
Yeah, that one's a little rough.
Do I have to hug all people that fucking love Raging Bull? I have to apologize.
You might have to do a Tracy Morgan and apologize. To everybody.
Frank Vincent's
you might
in
have
this.
To
listen,
go
Vincent's
no,
in it.
Please don't convince me that it's great. It's like if somebody said they don't like Jaws, I would be very bothered by that.
Yeah, yeah.
But I didn't say I didn't like it. I don't know how to watch it.
That's another one. Hold on. Fucking Robert Shaw in Jaws when he gives that speech. What do you think?
Amazing.
The one where he the
tells about the fucking
the Hiroshima bomb.
Yeah, yeah. Tells about
that is that prob for me
Indianapolis. That was it.
I would probably say it probably would be in the top 10 time. But I like the scene where I'm a sucker in movies for the scene where the person explains the evil. In the movie.
Yeah.
When he scratches the board and he's like, you know.
Oh, that's a great scene.
Y'all know me.
Yeah.
That
know
is,
what I do
to
for
me,
a
is
living.
Better than the one on the boat.
Yeah.
I know people would probably tell me, shut the fuck, but when he explains that this fish will swallow you whole.
Yeah.
It costs $10,000 to fuck with this fish. This punk ass two you getting, that'll help. I'll point at that motherfucker and say, there it is.
Down you go.
So
that,
if you
yeah.
want your fucking, that scene is phenomenal.
That's a good one. Yeah, I like that one too.
That's a good argument.
When he leaves.
That is a great scene.
Mayor, chief, ladies, gentlemen.
And then
he just walks out.
And he's just driving his boat around watching them off. Just liver. Yeah, really? You caught that tiger shark? Go fuck yourself. That was eating children
that
on this
ain't
fucking
the motherfucker. Yeah, he just drives by like, looking at them all patting themselves on the back.
He's pleasure boning. Yeah, everyone else thinks they're catching a monster.
You think that's ain't that kid? Yeah, hi, everybody.
Yeah.
I'm not saying, you don't have to convince me about Raging Bull. I just recently sat and absorb Rocky.
I used
to say Rocky 3 was better than the original. Mm. I'm entertained by Rocky 3.
Yes.
But Rocky is
a story,
great film.
Right. Rocky as a story
is a better
is great.
Film.
As an action movie and with a little more of a cartoony character thing with Mr. T, you can't fucking beat 3. Mr. T in 3, that was the best thing he's ever done. Not that he's done all
he may be, and if you're talking villains, he could be in the top 10 villains of all time.
That was a great fucking bad guy.
He was brutal.
Hey, woman, why don't you come by?
I'm going to fuck your wife,
Rocky.
What
a real man's like. He's like right in front of the public, the beloved Rocky in his own fucking city, and he's saying he's going to fuck his wife.
The truth is, we both started out on the same corner, and I got lucky with my life, and it's driving you nuts.
Yeah. Philadelphia salutes its favorite son, Rocky Balboa.
They give him a statue, and then Mr. T.
Why don't you tell all these nice folks why you've been ducking me?
Oh,
this guy is a wrecking machine. You know, you've got a big mouth.
Come on, come on, close it, Balboa.
The whole world was scared of him.
Come on, Balboa.
Balboa was a fine champion, but his time has passed.
See that look in their eyes, Rocky?
Ah, shit.
Gotta get that look back, Rocky.
Yeah.
I'm the tiger, come on. I'm gonna destroy any man who tries to take what I got.
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna torture him. I'm gonna crucify him.
Basically, Tyson.
For the first time, way before Tyson.
Why not? There's
nothing wrong with being afraid.
You thought I was tough? This jump will kill you.
Bye. You wake up after a few years thinking you're a winner, but you're not.
There is no tomorrow.
You're really losing.
Well, I don't believe it.
There is no tomorrow.
Oh, shit.
Dang, 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 dang.
That's how they all start. You gotta get the bell. Come on, yeah, Rocky, you're kicking ass now. Fuck that clever Lang.
It's Rocky's greatest challenge.
That's the old school trailer.
Yeah.
His marriage.
Voice.
And his manhood. Against his most devastating and dangerous opponent.
I'll
bust you up.
Go for it.
Go for it.
Sylvester Stallone, Talia Shire, Burgess Meredith, Carl Weathers, Burt Young, and introducing Mr. T.
Introducing
Rocky III, an American tradition.
That was great.
Mr. T was so good. I rooted for Rocky.
Yeah.
Can I tell you something? That stupid music to this day gives me the goosebumps.
What's
man.
The best scene?
What the fuck?
In all 12 movies.
The best scene?
Scene.
Oh, shit. I don't
in
know.
In all of them. I got mine.
Nah, that's
not
that's,
even a challenge.
That's a tough one. I was thinking
I won't stop fighting.
Come here, Rocky.
Well, I was thinking I won't fight no more, you know, because you're sick in the bed.
Come here.
When?
What are you waiting for? It's so corny, but it hits me every time. Yeah. Like, there you go, bitch. Let him get his shit together.
Right. I think it's in every movie when they go through the montage, the workout montage, and then it ends with the...
Yeah.
And the music, and you're like, here comes the fight,
But the movie has to tell. He doesn't get his shit together until that music starts.
Yeah.
He might have his shit together, but nope, the music hasn't started yet, so he still has to figure out a couple more things.
Yeah. The Rocky music, don't confuse going stronger with ding,
no. ding, that's when it goes, yeah.
That's a different
ding, ding, ding,
music.
Ding. That's the fucking like crazy. All right, there's gonna be some fucking ass kicking.
And Burgess Meredith was just great in those movies.
Ah.
How many did he make? Well, which one did he die in? Three?
He died in three.
Died in three.
Three, right?
Yeah, fucking.
He died
fucking
in
Mr.
Three.
T killed the motherfucker.
Which we talked about years ago, how Rocky's crying in three.
Yeah.
You should have laughed at it, but.
You couldn't understand a word he was fucking saying.
I think but it
he
was real.
Upset. But he was upset.
Because he's like, I'm going to do seven more movies, but Mickey's dead. How can you kill Mickey?
And it was real because, the, you know, Burgess Meredith didn't have many years left to begin with. And now you're killing him off in this great fucking series.